Hi Karen, it's me, Elise, again here with Charlie. We're going to work on loose-leash walking, just kind of do another review. Hopefully you get this one, so it'll be a lot easier for you. Basically, in order to do loose-leash, we need to work on heel. It doesn't harm the dog, it's mentally stimulating as well as physically stimulating, and it also gives them a job. They're like, oh, I got to keep up with mom or dad or whoever. So you want to have them at your side, starting off with the leg closest to the dog. You'll have them kind of tight, but not too tight. And then once they get used to this heel, then they're gonna actually have the leash where it's loose, and you'll not have any pulling or any issues like that. It's also better because if you have a dog that's over here and over here and over here, then something could happen. You know, another dog could come up and he's darting around, acting crazy, and the other dog just like, oh, you know, goes crazy on him. So we're gonna attempt him to make him heel. We do use treats. I use treats for heel because it gets their attention and makes them more focused on you. You can also have them focus on your face so they know when to go. We're gonna do some commands when we're heeling. If we're gonna take them to the right, we say right. If we're gonna take them to the left, we say left, turn around. Just give them like a little oomph, to kind of a oomph word to get them to go a different direction. Charlie, come in. Whenever we're done heeling, we're gonna have them sit. Like if we were walking and we came up to a street, and we're gonna have them sit, and then that way we can cross the street safely. So again, we're gonna start him off on the side. I'm actually more of a lefty, so I'm gonna start him on my left side. It's easier for me. And so we're just gonna walk back and forth. When we get to the end, and we're gonna say turn around or move or whatever. Whatever your word wants to be, and let him know that you're making a turn. So anyways. We've got a little chicken treats here. Make him sit. Good boy. Ready? Heel. Again, starting off with the leg. Side of the dog. Honestly, like, he's doing great. You don't want him too far in front, not too far behind, but kind of more at your side. If we enter through a gate, again, we want him to sit, wait before we go through, or if he's by our side, he can go through with us. So he kind of keeps up with me. We can say faster, 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 slower, slower, slower. So that way he knows that if you're going to speed up, it can be faster, 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 faster. And again, slower, 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 slow him down. And make him walk at your pace. So we're going to go left, left. Good boy. We're going to go right, right. Too. great attempt. We'll see if he can heal beside me. Off leash. Charlie. Charlie, come. Nope. You ready? Is there something different? Charlie, come here. Also, if you have an issue with control of him, you can also use the leash backwards. And it acts as like a little, it tightens whenever he pulls on you. So if you have it over here, you can pull out. Heel. Good boy. And then if he goes to going crazy or whatever, you can just give him a tiny little jerk. And he'll, if he responds a little more, he'll a little more pressure. Good boy. And Lulu's sitting now too. So anyways, if you want to try, just put him on a heel. And then if he has to go potty, he'll let you know. A dog's body language will change. And then when he has to go potty, you can just stop, stand there, let him have a loose leash, let him do his business, and then again, heel. Put him back on a heel, and go again. This has been Leslie's training. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. Try to sit. Good boy. This has been Mrs. Training with Charlie, and we hope you enjoyed it.